for he is good.
His steadfast love endures forever.
Let Israel say, his steadfast love endures forever.
Open to me the gates of righteousness, that I may enter through them, and give thanks to the Lord.
This is the gate of the Lord. The righteous shall enter through it.
I thank you that you have answered me and have done my salvation.
The stone that the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone.
This is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes.
This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Save us, we beseech you, O Lord. O Lord, we beseech you, give us success.
Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord.
We bless you from the house of the Lord.
The Lord is God, and he has given us light. Bind the festal procession with branches up to the horns of the altar.
You are my God, and I will give thanks to you. You are my God, and I will extol you.
I'll give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his steadfast love endures forever.
Join in the prayer of confession. Have mercy, O God, according to your steadfast love. According to your abundant mercy, blot out our transgressions. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Almighty God, in raising Jesus from the grave, you shattered the power of sin and death. We confess that we remain captive to doubt and fear, bound by the ways that lead to death. We overlook the poor and the hungry, and pass by those who mourn. We are deaf to the cries of the oppressed, and indifferent to calls for peace. We despise the weak, and abuse the earth you made. Forgive us, God of mercy. Help us to trust your power. Change our lives and make us new, that we may know your joy and life abundant, given in Jesus Christ, the risen Lord. The Almighty and merciful Lord grant you pardon, forgiveness, and remission of all your sins. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
wakens my ear to listen as those who are taught. The Lord God has opened my ear, and I was not rebellious. I did not turn backward. I gave my back to those who struck me, and my cheeks to those who pulled out the beard. I did not hide my face from insult and spitting. The Lord God helps me. Therefore, I have not been disgraced. Therefore, I have set my face like flint, and I know that I shall not be put to shame. He who vindicates me is near. Who will contend with me? Let us stand up together. Who are my adversaries? Let them confront me. It is the Lord God who helps me, who will declare me guilty.
Thank you.
St. Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Just a quick word. We, of course, have this, we do the Passion narrative during this time, and so there's going to be parts that are played. I'm Jesus today. What that means exactly. This is not the time I want to be Jesus, all right? But Carol is the narrator, and then Craig is Peter and Pilate. So when we read through it, then when we get to the hymns, they'll be unannounced. So we'll just play them, just go into it, so that it'll be a seamless.
Now the festival of unleavened bread, which is called the Passover, was near. The chief priests and the scribes were looking for a way to put Jesus to death, for they were afraid of the people. Then Satan entered into Judas, called Iscariot, who was one of the 12. He went away and conferred with the chief priests and officers of the temple police about how he might betray Jesus to them. They were greatly pleased and agreed to give him money. So he consented and began to look for an opportunity to betray Jesus to them when no crowd was present. Then came the day of unleavened bread, on which the Passover lamb had to be sacrificed. So Jesus sent Peter and John, saying,
"Go and prepare the Passover meal for us, that we may eat it."
They asked him, "Where do you want us to make preparation for it?" He said to them,
"Listen, when you have entered the city, a man carrying a jar of water will meet you. Follow him into the house he enters and say to the owner of the house, 'The teacher asks you, where is the guest room where I may eat the Passover with my disciples?' He will show you a large room upstairs, already furnished. Make preparations for us there."
So they went and found everything as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover meal. When the hour came, he took his place at the table, and the apostles with him. He said to them,
"I have eagerly desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. For I tell you, I will not eat it until it is fulfilled in the kingdom of God."
Then he took a cup, and after giving thanks, he said,
"Take this and divide it among yourselves, for I tell you that from now on I will not drink from the fruit of the vine until the kingdom of God comes."
Then he took a loaf of bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to them, saying,
"This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me."
And he did the same with the cup after supper, saying,
"This cup that is poured out for you is the new covenant in my blood. But see, the one who betrays me is with me, and his hand is on the table. For the Son of Man is going as it has been determined, but woe to that one by whom he is betrayed."
Then they began to ask one another which one of them it could be who would do this. And a dispute arose among them as to which one of them was to be regarded as the greatest. But he said to them,
"The kings of the Gentiles lorded over them, and those in authority over them are called benefactors, but not so with you. Rather, the greatest among you must become like the youngest, and the leader like one who serves. For who is greater, the one who is at the table or the one who serves? Is it not the one at the table? But I am among you as one who serves. You are those who have stood by me in my trials, and I confer on you, just as my Father has conferred on me, so that you may eat and drink at my table in my kingdom, and you will sit on thrones judging the 12 tribes of Israel. Simon, Simon, listen. Satan has demanded to sift all you like wheat, but I pray for you that your own faith may not fail, and you, when once you have turned back, strengthen your brothers."
And Simon Peter said to him,
"Lord, I am ready to go with you to prison and to death."
Jesus said,
"I tell you, Peter, the cock will not crow this day until you have denied three times that you know me."
He also said to them,
"When I was with you, when I sent you out without a purse, bag, or sandals, did you lack anything?"
They responded, "No, not a thing." He said to them,
"But now the one who has a purse must take it, the one who has no sword must sell his cloak and buy one. For I tell you, the scriptures must be fulfilled in me. And he was counted among the lawless. And indeed, what is written about me is being fulfilled.
They said, Lord, look, here are two swords. He replied,
it is enough.
Thank you.
middle of the courtyard and sat down together. Peter sat among them. Then a servant girl, seeing him in the firelight, stared at him and said, "This man also was with him." But Peter denied it, saying,
"Woman, I do not know."
A little later, someone else, on seeing him, said, "You also are one of them." But Peter said,
"Then I am not."
Then, about an hour later, still another kept insisting, "Surely this man also is with him, for he is a Galilean." But Peter said,
"I do not know what you are talking about."
At that moment, while he was still speaking, the cock crowed. The Lord turned and looked at Peter. Then Peter remembered the words of the Lord, how he had said to him, "Before the cock crows today, you will deny me 3 times." And he went out and wept bitterly. Perverting our nation, forbidding us to pay taxes to the emperor, and saying that he himself is Messiah, a king. Then Pilate asked him,
Are you the king of the Jews?
He answered,
So you say.
Then Pilate said to the chief priests and the crowds,
I find no basis for an accusation against this man.
But they were insistent and said, He stirs up the people by teaching throughout all Judea, from Galilee where he began even to this place. When Pilate heard this, he asked whether the man was a Galilean. And when he learned that he was under Herod's jurisdiction, he sent him off to Herod, who was himself in Jerusalem at that time. When Herod saw Jesus, he was very glad, for he'd been wanting to see him for a long time, because he had heard about him and was hoping to see him perform some signs. He questioned him at some length, but Jesus gave no answer. The chief priests and the scribes stood by, vehemently accusing him. Even Herod, with his soldiers, treated him with contempt and mocked him. Then he put an elegant robe on him and sent him back to Pilate. That same day, Herod and Pilate became friends with each other before they had been enemies. Pilate then called together the chief priests, the leaders, and the people and said to them,
You brought me this man as one who was preferred to the people. And here I have examined him. In your presence, I have not found this man guilty of any of your charges against him. Neither has Herod. For send him back to us. Indeed, he has done nothing to deserve death. I will therefore have him flogged and release him.
Then they all shouted together, Away with this fellow! Release Barabbas for us! This was a man who had been put in prison for an insurrection that had taken place in the city and was for murder. Pilate, wanting to release Jesus, addressed them again, but they kept shouting, Crucify him! Crucify him! A third time he said to them,
Why? What evil has he done? I have found him in no ground for the sentence of death. I will therefore have him flogged and then release him.
But they kept urgently demanding with loud shouts that he should be crucified, and their voices prevailed. So Pilate gave his verdict that their demand should be granted. He released the man they asked for, the one who had been put in prison for insurrection and murder, and he handed Jesus over as they wished.
Blessed are and the wombs that never bore, and the breasts that never nursed. Then they will begin to say to the mountains, fall on us, and to the hills, cover us. For if they do this when the wood is green, what will happen when it is dry?
Two others also, who were criminals, were led away to be put to death with him. When they came to the place that is called the skull, they crucified Jesus there with the criminals, one on the right and one on the left. Then Jesus said,
Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing.
And they cast lots to divide his clothing. And the people stood by watching. But the leaders scoffed at him, saying, He saved others. Let him save himself if he is the Messiah of God, his chosen one. Then the soldiers also mocked him, coming up and offering him sour wine and saying, If you are the king of the Jews, save yourself. There was also an inscription over him. This is the king of the Jews. One of the criminals who were hanged there kept deriding him, saying, Are you not the Messiah? Save yourself and us. But the other rebuked him, saying, Do you not fear God, since you are under the same sentence of condemnation? And we indeed have been condemned justly, for we are getting what we deserve for our deeds, but this man has done nothing wrong. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom, he replied.
Amen, I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise.
Thank you.
and asked for the body of Jesus. Then he took it down, wrapped it in a linen cloth, and laid it in a rock-hewn tomb where no one had ever been laid. It was a day of preparation, and the Sabbath was beginning. The women who had come with him from Galilee followed, and they saw the tomb and how his body was laid. Then they returned and prepared spices and ointments. On the Sabbath, they rested according to the commandment.
Will you please stand? The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
You made us in your image, sending us in your world to love and serve you, and to live in peace with your whole creation. From generation to generation, you have guided us, sending prophets to turn us from wayward paths into the way of righteousness. And out of your great love for the world, you sent your only Son among us to redeem us and to be the way of eternal life. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with the choirs of angels, with all the faithful of every time of flight, who forever sing to the glory of your most holy name. Accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, as a living and holy offering of ourselves, that our lives may proclaim the one crucified and risen. And as we remember all your mighty and merciful acts, we do take this bread and this wine for the gifts that you have given us and celebrate with joy this great victory. Therefore, let us proclaim the great mystery of faith. Courage to take up our cross and in full reliance upon your grace to follow him. Help us to love you above all else and to love our neighbors as we love ourselves, demonstrating that love in word and deed and in the power of your Holy Spirit. Give us strength to serve you faithfully until the promised day of resurrection, but with the redeemed of all the ages, we will feast with you at your table in glory. Through Christ, with Christ, in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, our glory and honor are yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. acknowledge our Savior Christ has taught us to pray. So we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever and ever. Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven, broken in death for our sake. Take and eat in remembrance that Christ died for you. And be thankful. The blood of Christ, the cup of salvation. Take and drink in remembrance that Christ died for you. And be thankful.
Thank you. surgery went well, and I'm glad it's all behind me. Thank you again.
Good to see you.
Thank you. Good to be here.
Well, please keep everyone on the prayer concern list in your prayers this week. And let's begin by singing to the Lord.
Thank you.
thanksgiving for the unsurpassable gift of reconciliation to God, which he has freely given. Never fail to live as his servants, trusting in the power of his reign. May the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with each of you and remain in your hearts now and evermore. Go in love and peace.